Welcome to Retro Toy Review. My mission, take you back to your youth by locating, opening, and reviewing retro toys. Ah, yes, the A-Team, the iconic action-adventure TV show from the 1980s. It was about a group of ex-military, wrongly accused for a crime they didn't commit, on the run from the U.S. government and helping the everyday Joe. If you could find them and pay their fee, of course. You see, these guys were heroes for hire and the best of the best. Starring the charismatic George Peppard, Battlestar Galactica's Dirk Benedict, crazy old Dwight Schultz, and of course, Mr. T. The show first aired after Super Bowl XVII on January 30th, 1983, with the casting of leading man and movie star George Peppard, famous for his role in Breakfast at Tiffany's opposite Audrey Hepburn. The show was a guaranteed success. But the real icing on the cake was the inclusion of the sensational Mr. T. Fresh off his role in Rocky III, T was cast as B.A. Baracus, the A-Team's tough guy. You see, Mr. T was a pop culture icon, popular with adults and kids alike. This sent the show into the stratosphere as far as ratings were concerned. People just couldn't get enough of Mr. T. He was everywhere. He had his own cartoon series and even his own cereal. It was made up of T-shaped pieces that tasted like Captain Crunch. Not very exciting, but it was Mr. T! We had to have it. The A-Team was a huge success and lasted for 5 seasons, from 1983 all the way to 1987, totaling nearly 100 episodes. And because of the A-Team's popularity as a TV show, inevitably, toys had to be made. And here they are, the A-Team, in action figure form. Made by Galoob in 1983, with this card you get all 4 figures. Yep, the entire A-Team all at once. The figures are bright and colorful and come with a ton of accessories. But right off the bat, we can see that something is amiss. Marked down to $1? That doesn't bode well. Oh, look at the back. How boring. It's just black and white showing other stuff in the toy line. Ugh. I got a bad feeling about these guys. Well, let's get them open and see what they're like. Here they are, all 4 members of the A-Team. Yep, they sure are colorful. We've got Hannibal, B.A., Face, and Murdoch. These guys are all 3¾ inches, and they're definitely styled after G.I. Joe, with the same articulation. Right away, we'll see that these guys really don't look like their real-life counterparts. And they're definitely not dressed like they are on the TV show. What's with all these crazy color outfits? Oh, I see. Uh-huh. Gloob cheaped out. From the waist down, these guys all 4 use the exact same mold. Yep, look at those legs and feet. Same old mold, just different colors. Not only are they wearing the wrong outfits, but they don't really look like they're supposed to. These guys don't look like the A-Team. I mean, they did a decent job on Hannibal. He kind of looks like Peppard. And I like the way they painted Murdoch's eyes with them looking to the side. He looks kind of crazy. But if it wasn't for the mohawk, you couldn't even tell this was Mr. T. And look at Face! What happened to his head? His neck's all bent to the side. Ah! Oh. The plastic on these guys feels cheap. But the strangest thing, look at their heads. They're made of rubber. Yep, squishy rubber heads. I've never seen that on a 3¾-inch action figure. Ever! They come with a ton of accessories. Machine guns, backpacks, mortar launchers, flamethrowers. But they're cheap too. Look how skinny these guns are. They don't even stay in the figure's hands. They just keep falling out. And the backpacks just look dopey. And like I said before, these guys are just like G.I. Joes, which means they'll fit in their vehicles. Isn't it crazy to see B.A. and Murdoch driving a his tank? That also means you can use the G.I. Joe's weapons on these guys. The G.I. Joe's guns are thicker, so they stay in their hands better. But a couple times I tried to do it, and their thumbs broke off. Ugh, what cheap toys. When lined up with G.I. Joes, they sort of blend in. They do look like G.I. Joes, except You can tell they're cheap. Made of cheap plastic and crappy looking. And these guys were more expensive than G.I. Joe's because you were getting four. Imagine being a kid, getting the whole A-team for Christmas or your birthday, and when you get them out of the package, they turn out to be a bunch of junk. How disappointing. They aren't the A-team, they're the B-team. It'd be like in the TV show. You know how the A-team's really hard to find, but when you locate them, you get the best of the best? Imagine some poor person spending all that time trying to find them, only to get some cheap substitute.
10 years ago, a crack commando unit was sent to prison by a military court for a crime they didn't commit. These men promptly escaped from maximum security stockade to the Los Angeles underground. Today, still wanted by the government, they survive as soldiers of fortune. If you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire...
Who did you expect? We're the B team! I ain't getting on no pains, Murdoch!
Have some milk.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Well, that's what these toys are like. So, what kind of score am I going to give these guys? Well, they pretty much suck. But because of the fact they do blend in with G.I. Joe, and I get a kick out of Hannibal, I'm going to give them a gracious 2. The A-Team. A great TV show. So much fun to watch. But the toys are terrible. Thanks for stopping by. And tune in next time.
I love it when a plan comes together.